Happy Monday. Welcome back to Daybreak. If you've got kids, chances are they know native Alaska wildlife pretty much by the time they can talk.
But here's some common farm animals seem exotic. And as part of our ongoing series, Harvesting Alaska, KTVA 11's Rachael Penton met a woman educating young Alaskans about farm life, and she joins us live from the hillside this morning. Good morning, Rachael.
Yeah, good morning, guys. The Learning Farm, just located off of Huffman Road at the end of a road behind a neighborhood. You might not have noticed it before, but out here, plenty of animals, every kind of farm animal you would expect to see. And as we learned in this week's Harvesting Alaska, owner Deborah Baines is using those animals to teach some kids some very important life lessons.
You won't find any moose or bear here.
My name is Deborah Baines. This is my little farm. I've been here for 39 years.
But you will find plenty of horses, goats, chickens, and other traditional farm animals.
That's Love Dove. This is Snickerdoodle. This is Cloche. Alma, short for All My Love. Aurora, Itty Bitty, and Zoe. I really wanted an educational program, not a petting zoo. Why don't we head up to the barn?
Before Deborah Baines opened the Learning Farm 6 years ago, she took her animals into schools.
Let me show you.
While many Alaskans are familiar with farming, she found out that many kids didn't know much about typical farm life.
There's so many wool on you.
You know, I've had a little girl came out the other day and she was petting Loki here and she was like, I can't believe I'm touching a sheep. I just can't believe I'm touching a sheep, you know. So there's just not a lot of opportunity for that in Alaska.
These days, the students come to her.
Do you want to do two groups or three?
At summer camps and on field trips, like this excited group of kindergartners from Aquarian Charter School.
You have cute little ponies.
Thank you. I do have two ponies, and we'll be able to go over and brush the ponies.
The students are learning about what the animals eat and how to feed them. It's also an opportunity for them to see firsthand where their food comes from.
You two can go in and there's a nest. Pick one egg. Is there any eggs in there?
Yep, there's mine.
Oh, okay, just get one.
Baines wants the students to make the connection between animals and the products that they produce.
What happens after they lay the eggs?
Yeah, because it's a secret, but they have to get married.
Are these eggs the same color?
No, not all of them.
Nope. Are they the same size?
No.
Nope. Nope, that's how it is. The different chickens lay different size eggs and different colors.
See how deep that is.
They also get the chance to see how some of these products are made. Today, they're collecting wool from Salt the sheep and turning it into fiber.
Just dunk it very nice, very carefully, about 10 times.
Okay.
And then let's dunk it in the next rinse water. They'll see the sheep, the wool, cleaning it, the whole thing, right to yarn and an end product.
But most importantly, Deborah wants the students to cultivate love and compassion for living things.
They learn here how to, you know, we respect the animals, respect their space, we respect so we don't scare them, we don't chase them. So that can be carried on with home pets, cats, you know, dogs, rabbits.
Oh my God!
That's a lesson, she says, that goes beyond the farm.
I think the favorite is hearing how it positively impacted the kids, how excited they are, you know, when they leave here and they talk about it. And I guess that's, you know, positively impacting children.
And registration for those camps is open. They start May 30th, so next week. Ooh, and I'm going to feed some baby goats here. Baby goats are awesome. And Deborah Baines is going to tell us a little more about those summer camps coming up in just a few minutes, about some of the other programs that she offers out here at the Learning Farm. You get to do fun stuff like this. That's not bad for a Monday, right? I love feeding baby goats. They're adorable and very friendly. So, again, we're going to talk to her in just a few minutes. These are saltines, by the way. Fun fact, did not know baby goats like to eat saltines.